Greetings, everyone. I'm Scott Berlin. On behalf of the School of Social Work at Grand Valley State University, it's my pleasure to extend our warmest welcome to members of the Class of 2020 from the Bachelor of Social Work and the Master of Social Work programs, along with their family, friends, partners, spouses, children, and loved ones. Graduates, we have a feeling you've been looking forward to this day for a while. Well, it's here and you're done. Faculty members, administrators, staff, and other members of the Grand Valley community are excited to wish you our sincerest congratulations. Graduates, please don't forget to thank your loved ones who've supported you emotionally, physically, and financially through this journey. For family members and friends who don't know much about our profession, here are some facts about social work. Social work is one of the fastest growing careers in the United States, according to the U.S. Department of Labor statistics. Social workers help people overcome some of life's most difficult challenges: poverty, discrimination, abuse, addiction, physical illness, divorce, loss, unemployment, educational problems, disability, and mental health issues. They help prevent crises and counsel individuals, families, and communities to cope more effectively with the stresses of everyday life. Professional social workers are found in every facet of our community life: in our schools, our hospitals, mental health clinics, senior centers, elected office, private practices, criminal justice settings, the military, corporations, and in numerous public and private agencies that serve individuals, families, groups, organizations, and communities in need. Professional social workers are also the nation's largest group of mental health services providers, including therapists and counselors. There are approximately 200 social workers in national, state, and local elected offices. Currently, our mayor of Grand Rapids, Rosalind Bliss, and the president of Grand Valley, Filomeno Montella, are both social workers. As we can see from our list, social workers can do so many wonderful things. Students, graduates, we know that you finished your education during turbulent and trying times. All of us recognize and applaud your strength and resilience through these past very difficult weeks and months. In many ways, your ability to be patient, caring, strong, and resilient through this time are the things that will make you wonderful social workers as you move into your careers. So thank you, and we appreciate your patience. As we begin our ceremony tonight, graduates, please think about those friends, colleagues, and mentors who you've met, the things you've learned about social work, the things you've learned about yourselves, and all the ways in which you've changed. Please go forth and do great work. Make your place in the world a better place. Please keep in touch. We hope to see you soon in person. Congratulations. We're so proud of you. Thank you very much.
Hello, everyone. Good evening. I'm Cray Mulder, the MSW director. I just want to take a moment and congratulate you on your many accomplishments during the past 1, 2, or 3 years. I know you've all worked really hard. You've completed hundreds of hours at your field sites. You've been adaptable and flexible with losing your internship sites and moving remote. You've really embraced the challenges. Some of you have completed service learning both domestically and abroad, class projects, community engagement, the poverty class, El Salvador, Ireland. We hope you've enjoyed your time in the MSW program. We hope you've learned a lot. We value your contributions to the MSW program, and we're eager to see what the future brings for each of you. We hope that you stay in touch, and we want to see you again soon. Please reach out to us. We hope you take interns in the future. We hope you attend CEU events when you're licensed, and we're proud to have you as a GVSU alum. Thank you and congratulations. Best wishes to you and your family.
Good afternoon. I am Robin Smith Colton, the BSW director, and I just want to have a couple remarks about all of your great accomplishments in the School of Social Work. So as BSW students in particular, you have engaged in many classroom learning experiences, field work, and you've developed many skills for working with individuals, families, groups, and communities. We know that all of your opportunities have allowed you to stretch yourself and to grow into a professional social worker. So we are really looking forward to all that you will accomplish with your BSW degree. We know you will continue to be change agents for social justice, particularly during these difficult times. So we wish you the best as you engage in social work opportunities on your social work trajectory. Please remember what you've learned in the classroom. Please remember what you learned in your field experiences. And we look forward to seeing all the great things that we know you will do in the social work profession. Again, congratulations.
Hello, I'm Dr. George Grant Jr., Dean of the College of Community and Public Service. And to the School of Social Work graduates, I want to say congratulations. When you started your academic journey, there were signposts to help you along the way to reach that final destination, graduation. So on behalf of the College of Community and Public Service, wish you all the best and hope you enjoy the next part of your adventure.
Hello, I'm the Associate Dean at the College of Community and Public Service. I congratulate all of you who have earned your BSW and MSW this semester. I am sure you are a bit disappointed that you won't get to hear your name mispronounced at commencement. But we will be waiting for you to return in October or December for that important ritual. And even if you can't make that return, I know you will think of us fondly every month when you make your student loan payment. Best of luck to everyone.
Congratulations, graduates. We are so very proud of you. You have shown tremendous resilience and made it through this trying time successfully. And we are so very proud of you. And we know you're going to make significant contributions to the lives of your clients and communities that you serve throughout your career. And we congratulate you. Have a wonderful career.
Hello, graduates. I'm Dr. Greensmith, Diane Greensmith. I'm sure I've not taught all of you, but I've taught some of you, many of you, and I've seen you walking around. I've seen you as BSW students, and I've seen you and had you as MSW students. Today, however, you are not a student. You are a graduate. We here at Grand Valley and the School of Social Work are so excited about everything you've done. You have struggled. You have weathered the storm. You have been resilient. Some of you have families to take care of you, to take care of. Some of you have had to work part-time jobs and do your internship. And some of you just had insurmountable things going on in your lives, things we probably did not know anything about. But despite all of the challenges you may have had, you continue to move forward. Today is a special occasion for you. Although we're not with you physically, we are with you emotionally and spiritually. We're connected with you. We know that you had to move out of the classroom and work at home. We know you learned all sorts of technological strategies to do online. Guess what? You weren't alone. We had to learn those same skills and those same strategies. And those of you who are BSW graduates and you're coming into the MSW program, you are now ready. You have the skills to get you there. So congratulations. We're looking forward to seeing you as alumni. We're looking forward to working with you as peers and as colleagues. We hope that you enjoy this day and this time. Enjoy your families as you celebrate and come back and see us. We may have to work with you in your capacity as a social work professional in the future. Take care of yourselves. Enjoy yourselves. Thank you.
Well, BSW and MSW students, my name is Emily Nichols, and I just wanted to say congratulations on all the hard work and you've put in over the school year. I know this is not how any of us wanted to end this academic year or end your program, but I am so proud of all of the hard work and resilience and dedication that I have seen all of my students demonstrate over the past few weeks. The support that you all have for one another has been really special to see, and I hope that you all continue to have that support for one another as you move on into your careers. I'm so excited to see all the great things that you're going to do in your careers, and I hope you keep in touch to share those wonderful things. Again, congratulations, and I hope to hear from you all soon. Bye.
My name is Dr. Jamie Langlois, and I've been fortunate to teach many of you in the graduate program. You'll notice that I'm wearing a doctoral graduation cap. I ordered my regalia in January so I could wear it for the first time at your hooding and pinning ceremony. I completed my DSW last April. I'm excited to get to wear it today to recognize the achievements that you have completed and the obstacles that you have overcome to complete your degrees. I hope you will take a moment to celebrate all you have accomplished and thank your family and friends for their support. Congratulations.
Congratulations. You know, don't let any of this craziness that's gone on in the last month or two take away from the outstanding achievements and accomplishments that you've all made. It's just remarkable, and I'm happy for all of you, and I know you're going to do well. And as I would say if we were still in Capstone in the last class, today is the day you cross over from being a student to being a colleague, and I'm happy, happy, happy for you. So congratulations. Stay in touch. Let me help you if I can, and peace.
BSW and MSW graduates, congratulations. I am so happy for you. It isn't that long ago that I myself graduated from different parts of my education. But I want to remind you that as you get into your new jobs, remember this lesson. You can learn. You will learn how everything from the program fits into doing good social work. I wish you the very best. And again, congratulations.
This is my first year at Grand Valley, and it was your last year, and I had the privilege of learning with you. And I'm so grateful for the experience. You're obviously having one of the strangest undergraduate graduations of all time, but I hope it doesn't detract from your feeling of accomplishment and your sense of pride in what you've completed. So many of you have overcome odds and challenges and all your responsibilities that could have been too much, but in the end, they weren't. You did it, and I'm quite proud of you. And to all the BSW and MSW students, I want to say, as the entire planet emerges from a pandemic and its effects, I'm confident that your emergence will be unique and it will be powerful. Your experiences and perspectives will be essential, and I'm cheering you on because we will need your voice and your leadership. Congratulations on your achievement.
Graduates, I just want to say and give you my heartfelt congratulations for this great achievement of earning your BSW and MSW degrees. I know it's been a long road for many of you, and these past few months have been difficult. You've shown how adaptable you are, how resilient you are, and I'm sure those qualities are going to follow you into the field. I also want you to know that it's been a privilege and rewarding for me, and a rewarding experience for me to be part of your educational experience at Grand Valley. I look forward to seeing you in our social work community. I want to congratulate those people who have been supportive of you throughout your entire journey, throughout the program. And just, it's a privilege to have been part of this, and I look forward to calling you colleagues in the future. And I just want to say best to you as you get out there and practice in this field that's been just so rewarding for me, and I'm sure it will be the same for you. So again, congratulations, and if there's anything I can do for you, please let me know.
Hey BSW students, Katie Shirley here, wanting to wish you the best as you finish your chapter as an undergrad student at GVSU. Although your internship and classes couldn't end in person with well-earned celebrations, I'm hopeful that doesn't diminish the fact that you all worked extremely hard to get to where you are today. You made sacrifices, you took risks, maybe along the way you made a mistake or two. You had to wrestle with that document called a learning contract. But most important, you didn't give up. You just became the next generation of social workers. Welcome to the best profession in the world. I'm excited for your future. I hope you'll connect with me down the road and let me know you want to be a field supervisor for a GVSU BSW student. Best wishes and congratulations, class of 2020. We are proud of you.
Congratulations, class 2020. You have made it. We are experiencing a global pandemic none has ever seen before. The country needs well-educated social workers like you more than ever in the history. Class 2020, you have achieved your education success in a great time of needs. You are equipped to turn this crisis into a great opportunity to change. The future is yours. Go, Class 2020. So proud of you.
Hello, Class of 2020. I am very happy to share in the excitement of what you have accomplished in your journey through the social work program. I am looking forward to congratulating you in person in the near future. But for now, congratulations and best wishes on your next adventure.
Hello, graduates. My name is Dr. Patty Stobolea, and I am just here to say congratulations on this momentous accomplishment during this very unprecedented time. I hope you bring all the skills that you have learned at Grand Valley to the unique challenges that face you upon graduation. Best wishes and keep in touch. Thank you.
Hello, graduates. What an interesting time we find ourselves in, and I'm so sorry that we've ended our semester in the way that we did, but I want to take this time to congratulate you, and I'll let you know how proud I am of the work that you've been able to do, even under these fairly difficult circumstances at the end of our time together. I've had such a joy getting to know all of you at some point in your career at Grand Valley, and that's been one of the great pleasures of my life. Those of you who have had me in class know that I enjoy quotes, that you often see them in my PowerPoints. And so I wanted to leave you with this Maya Angelou quote. And she says, "My wish for you is that you continue. Continue to be who you are, to astonish the mean world with your acts of kindness." Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Hi, I'm Dr. Steve Smith. Congratulations on your graduation. You should be proud of your accomplishments. It's been a pleasure to work with all of you. And so you begin your journey in what we call the School of Hard Knocks. And you do this in the midst of a pandemic, which is likely the defining moment of your generation. You have a great responsibility here to learn all you can from these troubling times and use that knowledge to help prepare, well, all of us for the next time a crisis emerges. As your career progresses, remember most of all, you have learned quite a few new perspectives, new techniques, and a few new words to help you connect with others. I'd also like to remind you that these gifts of words, while they're very important, is really secondary to you being present with others, to listening to others closely, and of empathy to those in trauma. So go forth and always, always, always do what is interesting and challenging for you. Stay in touch. Bye.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I'm Dr. Euker, here to help you celebrate. Although we're all inclusive social workers, you've just joined a very exclusive club. BSWs, only one-third of American adults have a bachelor's degree. And for you MSWs, only 9% have a master's. And since I won't be able to see you graduate this spring in person, I want to provide you the virtual experience. So stand up, imagine yourself in cap and gown, processing across the Van Andel, which is full of your family and friends and supporters, there to help you celebrate your well-earned diploma. On behalf of the Grand Valley family and the Euker family, we want to leave you with a proper pomp and circumstance.
Hi, everybody. My name is Megan DeBeast, and I'm graduating with my bachelor's in social work. I would just like to start off by saying congratulations to the class of 2020. I know that this has not been an easy road or an easy journey for any of us. College is hard enough as it is, and things are far from normal right now, but you guys are doing great. We're here and we all made it. We've completed the classroom requirements and the internship hours and all of the assignments, and I couldn't be more proud of you. I know that some days and some weeks felt painfully long, or at least they did for me, between juggling school and internships and our jobs and our personal lives, but it's complete now and we've all endured and powered through and we made it. And I hope that you feel like you've grown and learned as much as I feel like I have in the past few years. Each and every one of us has such a different story and for how we've come where we are and the things that have made us into who we are. And just like many of you, my college career maybe doesn't look the same as the person next to me. So for me, Grand Valley was actually the fifth college that I've attended. So it's been kind of crazy for me at least. But before coming to Grand Valley, I was a student at the University of Nebraska, which I absolutely loved being at. UNL was the place where I actually found and fell in love with social work. And then Grand Valley has just been the place that's helped me to really grow and mature in that. But as I'm sure that you all have found out, life does not always go the way we plan. So after what I call a series of unfortunate events, for lack of a better word, I had to move back to Michigan on a whim. And with it being December and going into winter semester, my options were really limited. So I decided that I would apply to the schools in Michigan that I was interested in and just go to the first one that accepted me in January. So now here I am graduating from the Grand Valley about 2 years later. But despite that, you better believe that Grand Valley was not necessarily the first place I intended to be. I dreamt for years of graduating from the University of Nebraska and walking across the same stage that my dad had and so many other family members and just carrying on that legacy. But as I mentioned before, life doesn't go to plan always, and the trajectory that I had planned for my life then compared to how it actually now is so far different from what I thought it would be years ago. But despite that, I could not be more grateful for being at Grand Valley. So coming to Grand Valley has obviously been one of the most unexpected yet also rewarding opportunities and experiences that I've had in my life. It's been one that's really stretched me and grown my thinking from the assignments that I've done that have challenged me and the professors who have been so vulnerable and open with their experiences, and even to the friendships that have formed and changed me throughout the couple years and just everything in between. I truly can say that there is not an aspect that I would change. And when I sit back and reflect on the past 5 years of my college career in whole, my mind is brought to the many challenges that have happened, but without them, I truly would not be half the person I am today. And it's caused me to really have to rely on people, which isn't necessarily something that I'm always used to doing. So I've had to ask for a lot of help and have been able to actually really utilize the resources that Grand Valley has given to me, whether that be reaching out to my supervisor or my internship, not only for like workplace questions, but also in everyday life or a future career path, to the friendships that I made and the special people in my cohort who have loved me so well and encouraged me during the really tough times. So although my time at Grand Valley as a student is getting cut short and is now coming to an end, the memories and the relationships and experiences and the knowledge that I've gained, I'm going to be carrying for a lifetime. And it has just been so humbling to really think about the road that has led me to where I am today. And I feel nothing but thankfulness for it, and I really would not change a thing. So as we're all stepping forward into the next steps of our journeys, whether you are furthering your education or starting a family or entering the workforce or whatever the coming year looks like for you or what you think it's going to look like versus what it actually does end up looking like, I just want to challenge you to whatever it is that you're doing, do it fully, be fully there, and do it to the best of your ability. Just be present and practice the gratitude for the things that you do have, because things get so much better when we're thankful for them. Love those around you well and commit and really seize the experiences that you've been blessed with. Take in everything and learn everything that you can. Discover your gifts and use them wisely. If you're anything like me, you chose social work because you love people and you have a heart for them. So use that passion accordingly. Ooh, it isn't going to be an easy road, and we all know that. And we are in it for the money, we know that too, but we're in it for others, so make the difference that you can one life at a time. You're gonna be great, and I believe in you. Congrats again to the class of 2020.
Hey everybody, here we are, we've graduated. Congratulations, we've made it. We are a very unique and individual class. We are part of the first ever Grand Valley State University online graduation celebration, and hopefully we are the last ever online graduation celebration. As we go into this time, we're going to prepare to go into the field. Think about all of our staff and faculty at Grand Valley and the administration and what they went through to get us here, not only in the regular course over the past few years, but these past couple months. Think of all the extra effort, all the stress they had to go through to drop a lesson plan, put everything online so we can make it to where we are today. So thank you to everybody at Grand Valley that made it happen. So what's next? Where are we gonna go? What are we gonna do? Well, before we all got dismissed for the semester, one of our classmates made the statement, create something you weren't given. And that's pretty cool. Think about that, create something you weren't given. Well, we weren't given degrees, we earned them. We sat through classes, we did presentations, we did focus groups. We earned our degrees, nobody gave that to us. We didn't create those. So how do we create something we weren't given? Well, we go into the field as social workers, we're now professionals. We go in, we help build better communities, we improve people's lives. Think back over these last couple months, think of your stress, think of your achievement, and then relate that to your future clients. That's their everyday lives that we're dealing with. Then we need to approach them and use our experiences to empathize with what they are going through. Use your theories, use your methods, use your skills and intuition. Stay safe and do good things. Thank you.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shouts and kicks in my
and the land is dark, and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, or the mountain should crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry. No, I won't shed a tear. Just as long as you stand by me. And darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me. Stand by me. Stand by me, whenever you.